Okay, everybody. Now I just want to talk to you about the bug sock. One thing about hammocking here in the southeast is we have a lot of bugs. So that was one reason I was kind of iffy about going to hammocks to begin with, because I didn't really have the money to spend, you know, $160, $70, $80 on a war bonnet blackbird. So I was kind of wondering, you know, how I would do the hammock with a net. But when I came across the hammock, it was such a sweet deal. Even though I didn't have a net, I had to pick it up. And once I got it, of course, that, you know, led to other things, as it usually does. So I got to looking around, and I went to Randy Smith's site. It's called mydiygear.com. Now, he's, some people I think go by the name Papa Smurf. But anyway, he's got a cool little site. He actually makes a couple of different items for stoves, hammocks, tarps. He's got all kind of stuff on there, bug protection stuff. And he's also got, on some things, he's got instructions that you can kind of do it yourself, hence my DIY gear. But anyway, while I was going through there, I came across the bug sock, and he does have some instructions for making the bug sock yourself. It seemed quite easy, so I figured I'd go ahead and do it. Now I want to say too, real quick, he offers the instructions on his site, Randy does, but he also credits the original bug sock idea back to Just Jeff, which is also a big hammock guy, and many of you may know Just Jeff from maybe some of the hammock forums. I'm pretty sure he's probably on that, and he's also got a website, I believe it's called Just Jeff. But also Sergeant Rock also took the same idea and kind of expanded upon it and made it a little better. Now I didn't really get into a whole lot of detail of the first and second generations that they did. I pretty much followed the instructions that Randy posted on his site, and I pretty much went by his instructions. There was a couple of places I kind of skimped a little bit. He calls for some webbing and stuff like that, and I didn't really have any of the webbing, so I made do with some scrap seal nylon I had. But anyway, this is one that I made. In this stuff sack, it weighs 2.4 ounces, and this is made out of tulle, T-U-L-L-E. I got it at Walmart for $1. It was $1.27 square yard. I bought 7 yards and went home with 6 yards. I don't know how that worked out. But anyway, this is it. Like I say, it's made out of tulle, and it basically it fits around your hammock like a sock. Let's see. I spread it out here. I don't know how well you can see that. But anyway, this is it. So real quick, I want to show you how it goes on the hammock. So hang on a second. I guess I could explain real quick before I put it on the hammock how it goes on. Basically, one end of this is opened up, as you can see where this orange cord is. The hammock runs through there, and it comes out the other end, which is here, and the line comes out here. Now this end is all sewn, the top is all sewn. The only part that's not sewn is this end here, and that's where it goes over. Now that's one thing I like about the ridgeline on this hammock. Is it does give some support for the bug sock to stay up. So now I'm going to show you how it goes on. Hang on. And bam, there it is. I don't know how well you can see it because it is kind of a light color. But you can see it hangs down to here. And then here's the top of it. It cinches over on the head end. And then the foot end, like I said, the cord just slides through. So it's real simple to use. Obviously, I wouldn't put it up while I was out of it. Use it. I just uncinch it. I slide it back. And then whenever I get inside my hammock, I can sit up and pull it up. So, real quick, I'll show you that. And there it is. I'm inside my hammock. I have bug protection on. Can't no bugs get to me. One thing I will say about it, it does sag in on me just a little bit. I found that if I take something and put down in the bottom, it kind of puts a little bit of tension on it. Kind of pulls itself on the guy line here, or the ridge line, and it will actually tension it up a little bit and make it a little better. So, anyway, that's it. Sit here and not worry about any bugs getting on me. Whatever. Just enjoy it. I can still see above me real good. But anyway, I want to get out. Another nice thing, I could have just leave it there. If I'm getting in and out of the hammock a lot, I can just kind of leave it there. Do whatever, you know, just reach it. Send my way, just push it on down. Now sit back up. I'm using the trick all the hammockers do as far as lounging in a comfortable chair instead of on the ground. Taking my shoes off, putting my shoes on. If you're curious too, by the way, these are my Rock White 315s. Y'all watch that still. I guess I should have put this thing a little bit closer to the ground. But anyway, that's my bug net. Now the last thing I want to show you is my tarp. So hang on a second.